Video games have come a long way since their creation all those many, many years ago. Actually, it hasn't been that long. Just a little over 40 years, which is really impressive considering the strides that video game world has made in this time. What used to be pixelated figures on a giant monitor has evolved into amazing realistic graphics that you can carry around on your smartphone. And with this newly simplified version of gaming on your phone, accessibility has never been easier. And millions upon millions of people participate in the fun in mobile gaming every year. And why not? They're a blast. With so many different games to play, from the hardcore games like DC's Injustice to the grandma-friendly ones like Candy Crush, mobile game addiction is a real thing. I'm Brittany, and today on Leaderboard, we're counting down the 17 signs you may be addicted to mobile gaming. Let's get started. One, you constantly check your phone to see if you can play again. Mobile games can be punishing. Some games make you wait 5 minutes, other games make you wait 20 minutes, hours, days. So you constantly check your phone thinking, ugh, an eternity has passed, but it's only been a couple of seconds. And you do this over and over and over, and maybe you need a break there, buddy. Two, you love Facebook because you get free stuff. Maybe you need that boost in a certain level of 2 dots that you can only get if you tell all your friends to play the game through Facebook. You probably send out dozens of these a day to all your friends, only to realize these so-called friends have unfriended you because you won't leave them alone. I just want another life in Candy Crush, please. This is the last one, I promise. Three, your eyes are constantly aching. Come on. How many times have your parents told you never sit too close to the television because you'll go blind? It's an undeniable fact that just watching any laminated screen for too long during the day does hurt your eyes and vision. So, all those games you've been playing on your commute to school, work, the bathroom, during lunch, yeah, I know, at that red light, that's all taking a toll. And just maybe for 1 or 2 minutes, put the phone away and relax. But we both know that's not gonna happen. Four, you notice your productivity is rapidly decreasing. Playtime is playtime and work time is work time. But for you, the fun time is all the time. Maybe all those homework assignments you've been telling yourself you'll do every 5 minutes will magically get done when you finish your 80th level of Cut the Rope. Who needs homework when you're feeling a little green booger candy? Five, you feel so alone and anxious whenever you're not anywhere near your phone. FOMO, right? We all have it. We may have a certain someone in our lives or a pet or a family member that just can't imagine yourself being with. Out. And don't get me wrong, being away from your phone for too long is a little scary, but sometimes we get a little too attached. You just don't seem to be emotionally prepared to take another step without your phone in hand. You just need your Pokemon Shuffle. Man, I get it. Six, you find yourself lying about what you've been doing all day. Some of us may be addicted to mobile games, and we get very self-conscious about it. Despite us spending the entire day playing Jetpack Joyride, we don't want our friends to know that, right? So you tell them you've been hanging out with some friends they don't know and we'll never meet, and to never question you ever again, because why would they not believe you? They're your friend, right? Seven, mobile games are the only source of happiness. Studies have shown that as people become more addicted to video games, their main source of happiness and enjoyment in life becomes those video games. So maybe playing Minecraft on your phone is really the only thing you can go home to after a bad day that makes you feel better. I guess there's nothing bad about that when you think about it, right? Eight, you pretty much have a bank account dedicated for mobile games. There are plenty of free games out there, but there are even more you have to pay for. And then there are ones that you fall in love with and you can only get the advanced versions if you cough up some dough. And what about those weapons and armors that you need to acquire to advance in the game? Yes, the dreaded in-game purchases. Whatever it may be, your credit card is screaming at you to stop and let it breathe for a second. Sure, they may be just a dollar or two every now and then, but trust me, those add up, and before you know it, you're looking at a $500 bill. Maybe you didn't need those 200 hints in WordBrain. Nine, you constantly forget where you are and what you're doing. I guess this is more for the city folk who take public transportation to work or school. Maybe you just need to take a bus a couple stops to meet up with your friends somewhere. Okay, doesn't sound too bad. Hop on the bus, play a little Puzzles and Dragons. Shouldn't be too bad until you look up and you're at the end of the line and the sun has gone down. Maybe a little vacation from your smartphone is in store, my friend. 10, you dream about passing that one Candy Crush level that has been standing in your way for weeks. All right, maybe not just Candy Crush, but you get it. Dreaming about mobile games or seeing mobile games in your head when you doze off is probably a sign that you've been playing on your phone a little too much. No matter what you do, it's always gonna be there haunting you. 11, you get visibly upset whenever your internet or the server of your favorite video game goes down. In this day and age, getting upset over the occasional ineffectiveness of the whole interwebs is a common thing. The older folk might laugh at us for it, but you don't understand, Dad. We need them to play our games and play them now. You never get me, do you, Dad? I'm running away to a place that has perfect internet so I can play Words with friends all the time, and I will finally be happy. And oh, the internet's back? Oh, never mind, love you, Dad. 12, every morning you ask yourself, Why did I sleep so late? It's 10 p.m. You get ready for bed, you tuck yourself in, and you think maybe just one more game of Flow Free will take you on a simple ride to Snoozeville. After one level, you play another, and then another, and then another, and before you know it, it's 3 a.m. and you only have 3 more hours left of sleep. So what do? Play a couple more games, of course. And why not? We're young, we're wild, and we're free. Until you get your 2 hours of sleep and you wake up regretting every single minute of your life. Are you proud of yourself, mobile gamer? 13, you realize you're not in the same shape as you once were. It's no secret mobile gaming is not exactly a sport. You probably play at home in bed, curled up like a breakfast burrito. Maybe while you're eating a breakfast burrito. The more time you spend playing mobile games, the less time you spend doing the needed exercise your body requires. So maybe you find yourself having a few more aches and pains than you did yesterday. Or maybe that's just the cruel effects of aging that has gotten to you. 14, an old and worn out phone is no obstacle for you. I dropped my phone a dozen times and the screen broke, and I'm using a band-aid to hold the cover in place. If you're addicted to mobile games, chances are you're addicted to just having your phone around, and nothing can replace the bond you have with it. Cracked screen? No screen? No problem. A beat-up phone doesn't stop you from taking down legions of zombies with an army of deadly plants. 15. No space on your phone for new games? You don't need Instagram or Twitter or Snapchat. All the space on your phone is dedicated to the games you love. Sure, a novice may pick up your phone and be confused as to what is where and how to find the web browser because it's filled up with every single game imaginable. To you, this is the way it's supposed to be. You are in a mobile gaming heaven. 16, you find yourself being a lot less sociable. When you get invited to a party or a get together, you probably feel reluctant to go at first, but you give it a shot. When you get there, you realize you're not having fun because no one can relate to the amazing Temple Run game you just had earlier that day. If only people were as fun as mobile games. 17, you've been in the shame cube so long, you've redecorated the place. When it comes down to it, most of us mobile game addicts are fully aware of our addiction. We know we really should be somewhere doing something else with our time, but we just can't. Mobile games are programmed to be addictive and take over major parts of our lives. And as good as we feel about playing them, the after effects are quite serious. The guilt that hits you when you realize you should have been asleep hours ago, or that you should have done that homework assignment earlier that you're not stressing about. It's very embarrassing for us to accept mobile game addiction as a part of our culture. Just putting the phone down sounds easy enough, but when you do, you stress about what you could have been doing instead of taking down that weird alien virus thing in Tower of Defense. Then you accept this about yourself, love yourself anyway, and make yourself right at home in your mobile addiction shame cube. Thanks for watching the 17 signs you're addicted to mobile games. Which game are you addicted to? Let me know in the comments below, and if you like this video, be sure you've checked out some of our other videos by clicking the links in the annotations or the description. We have new videos dropping every week, so let us know what game you want us to cover next, and if you like getting more from your game, subscribe to the leaderboard, where we help you game smarter.